In this video, I'm going to show you how to fix the daylight savings time on an Avaya IP Office system the easy way using an XML file. Hi, I'm Jesse with Metroline Direct. If this video helps you out, do us a favor and hit that like button. And if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. This is a big problem for people. We want the time to update automatically. We'd like it to switch over when daylight savings time comes along, but it doesn't. So here's how to fix it. By the way, if this video seems rushed, it is almost daylight savings time, and this was a last minute decision, and I wanted to help people out, so I'm trying to get this done quick. Now you can manually enter in entries in the configuration, but who wants to do that, right? So that's why I made this XML file. I'll put a link to it in the comments so you guys can download it, and that way you don't have to enter in the entries yourself. And if you're outside of the United States, I only made this for time zones in the United States. If you're in Mexico or Canada, you can probably just choose a city that's in your time zone. And if you're outside the United States, I'll show you how to make your own entries in the time zone and how to send this to the system so that you should be all set once you see this video. If you have release 11.1.3 or higher, or release 12 or 12.1, this should be automatic. It's already built into the system on those releases. If you have an older release, that's when you're gonna run into a problem. I tried this out in release 9.0 and 11.1. So it should be good with those releases and anything in between, and even further back with that, probably back to release 7, I would say. The first thing you're going to need is the manager program. If you don't have the manager program, you can probably just Google it and download it. Okay, so get manager opened up, and you can click on the icon at the top here, or you can click on file, open configuration, log in. The default username and password should be administrator with a capital A. Click on System on the left, and then down at the bottom of the System section, you see this drop down, and you can see this has all the old dates in it from 2014 through 2023. Now we're going to click on the drop down next to Time Setting Config Source and change that to Voicemail Pro / Manager. Click OK at the bottom and save it. This should just be a merge, which means that it's going to take effect right away. And the default username and password is administrator with a capital A. Now it is recommended that we close manager for this. So we're gonna go ahead and close that. Go to the manager folder. The default location for the manager folder is the program files x86 folder, and then Avaya, and then IP Office admin suite, or your installation may say just IP Office, and that's fine. And then open up the manager folder. Scroll down to the bottom, and you should see this file called timezoneinfo.xml. I'm going to open that up, and I just want to show you the entries in here. So if you live in a country outside of the United States, just find your time zone and you can change the dates in that section. And you probably only just need to change the year, not the whole thing. And then save this file and you should be all set. Now let's take a look at this new file that I have here. You can see at the top is the Eastern time zone, and so we have the different time zones here in the United States. And then you can see the dates are going up to 2033. So we're going to go ahead and copy this file and paste it into the manager folder. And it's going to ask you if you want to replace the file in the destination. Go ahead and choose replace file in the destination because we want to replace that old file. It's probably going to ask you to continue as administrator. Go ahead and click on continue. If you're not the administrator of your computer, you'll need to enter in the username and password of the administrator account. Now let's go ahead and open up the configuration from the system again. Go back to the system section on the left. Click on the drop down next to time setting configuration source and change that back to what you had it set on before. Now, most people use SNTP. If you don't want your system to automatically reach out to a time server on the internet and keep itself accurate, you don't have to. You can click none and then you'll have to adjust the time manually, of course. but at least the time will switch over automatically twice a year during daylight savings time. And now look what happens here. Look at the dropdown. It has all these new dates that we had in our file. It's automatically updated in the configuration. So now we just need to click on OK and click on the save icon at the top. Or if you don't have the save icon, you can click on File, Save Configuration. Get that saved and you should be all set. All right, well, I hope this helped you out. If you're new to the channel, consider subscribing, and if this helped you out, do us a favor and hit that like button. I'm Jesse of Metroline Direct. Thanks for watching.